In this tutorial, we will look at how the spatial filter transformer can be used to determine spatial relationships. The spatial filter determines relationships, but only by testing against a user-defined criteria. Features are then filtered through the pass or fail port. Spatial relationships, also known as predicates, define how two or more spatial features interact with each other. For example, features may intersect or overlap, one feature may contain a second, or one feature may be inside or within another. You can find a more complete list of how predicates are defined by visiting the Spatial Relations FME Desktop Documentation link. The source datasets for this exercise are building footprints stored in AutoCAD DWG format and address points stored in an Esri file geodatabase format. We will use this data in a simple quality assurance exercise. We will build a workspace to test the contains criteria and see that each address falls inside a building. Let's start FME Workbench and open a new workspace. Add an Autodesk AutoCAD DWG DXF reader and select Building Footprints as the source dataset. If prompted, select only the Building Footprints layer. Add an Esri Geodatabase API reader and select Addresses as the source dataset. When prompted, select only the Postal Address table. Add a Spatial Filter Transformer. Connect the Building Footprints reader to the Spatial Filter port and the Postal Address reader to the Spatial Filter Candidate port. Open the Spatial Filter Parameters dialog and set the test to Perform as Contains. This will check which address points are contained within building footprints. Make sure that the filter type is set to Multiple Filters and that the pass criteria is set to pass against one filter. Connect an inspector transformer to each of the spatial filter passed and failed ports. Also connect an inspector to the building footprints feature type, so we can see that in the output. Go ahead and run the workspace. Let's change the colors of the point features displayed in the FME data inspector, so that we can differentiate between them. Now we can see which addresses fail the contains criteria with the building footprints.